Hello everyone. Today we're going to be going over Radio Personality Manager 1 for Harris Portables and Mobiles. This will cover the 7100, 7300, and the 5100 54 to the 5500. This includes all XG models. Code plug we're going to be using is for a XG75PE system model. For those who are not familiar with Harris, Select is going to be a Motorola Model 1. System is going to be a Model 3. Scan is going to be a Model 2. So first things first, I'm going to go to Options. Scroll down to P25, Wide Area Network Options. Hit, we're going to go ahead and delete what I have in there. Hit New. Enter in the system details. Hit OK. Now that we're done with that, we can scroll all the way up to Sets, Trunk Frequency Set, New Frequency Set, enter in a name, and here you're going to put in all the control channels. So 4568, 4518, 456.8125, 456, sorry, 451.8125. And 4695, 4645, 46955, 46455. And hit OK. You don't need to mess with any of the set options, just in turn frequencies. Gonna hit OK. Gonna go to group sets next. Here we're gonna put in under P25 group set. New group set, CTRS. Really, I'd recommend you make these like CTRS system wide, kind of separate them out like you would on a zone. We're add in ops. Just one thing to note as far as Harris goes, for the group ID, this is going to be your talk group ID, but you're going to do it in decimal. So instead of 7B7B, which as you can see, I can't type. You do 31611, do scan, and we're going to do another one, just get that example in, tack 1, instead of 7B7C, 7B7C, as you can see I can't put it there, we're going to do 31612. Go up here, add system ID, 13B, announcement group, yet again you can't do 911 as that's the hex, you do 2321. Make sure you hit scan. If you are encryption authorized and have keys loaded, you'd enable encrypted, AES, and then put in the key number in decimal. So we're just going to put all ones there for the moment. Don't touch suppressed number. Don't hit encrypt call parameters. Please. That will not function properly. Hit OK. We're going to go up to default channel ident set. This is going to be the ident table or band plan. Depends on your terminology. So once again, like we have to do with all the other manufacturers, you're going to skip. You're going to skip count. So we're going to go from 0, 1, 2. So this is now going to be VHF. So 146.000, transient offset of 1. Not 0, 1, and we're going to change this to 6.25. Make sure this is FDMA full rate, and then we're going to do 450.000, transmit offset of positive 5, and adjust it to 6.25, and make sure it's on FDMA full rate. Hit OK, and now we can add in our conventional frequencies. You're going to go under P25 conventional frequency set. Wow, I'm sorry, I have something stuck in my throat. Alright, that's much better. Hit new frequency set, CTRS, IO. There we go. So now, here, we're going to do CH1 and P. Make sure voice mode is P25, bandwidth is C4FM. That's going to make sure it transmits and receives P25, of course. Transmit frequency 456.8.1.2.5. Make sure it copies that properly. Squelch mode can either be normal or monitor. Power selectable up to you. NAC 13B 13B. Leave P25 group set and talk with ID blank. Enable scan if you would like. And then for RX channel guard, just put 111.1. This prevents it from Ellen squelching on every single bit of audio that you hear from the analog side. So then you do that for all your P25 channels. And then if we want to do an analog channel, CH5, and then we're going to put down 464 to 5. Select voice mode analog, narrow, and then put in our channel guards, 023, 023. Scan, signaling, if you have the MDC option loaded into your radio. If not, you do have to purchase that. Hit OK. And now, that's it. So hit OK. Close zones. Skip over zones. These will only appear on XG series radios. They're not exactly what you think. They show up separately. They're just mixes. Think of it as a zone that has channels from different zones into it. So it's a dynamic zone on a Motorola that you can't touch. It's interesting. As far as Harris goes, your systems would be your base zones. So we're at a new zone or system. Make this system wide or SYS, WD, WID, E. There you go. And of course you do that for, you know, area 1, area 2, area 3, and then add in Project 25 conventional system, Convio. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and delete these ones so they don't cause issues later. We're going to go to Project 25 conventional, select our group set, unit ID, MDC ID, this is going to be just the last four of unit ID, and then enable DTMF if you want. None of our repeaters will be enabled with it, but people like playing Happy Birthday with it, I guess. It's weird. Select your encryption type, AES, 111. We do not normally use encryption on the conventional frequencies, so we ask that you don't. Make sure both these checkboxes are unchecked, otherwise it'll allow people to send inhibits to you over conventional. Unit registration unchecked. P25 trunk systems, add in the wide area network, find the trunk set, the group set, and the ident set. We're then going to go to dynamic pro scan or enhanced CC if that's what you want. If you do select enhanced CC, I recommend using the band hunt start frequency, that's 450. Band hunt end frequency of 469 with 2.5 kHz spacing enabled as well. And then, of course, preferred systems. You know, if you had a friend that's nearby, you do 13B for our system ID, 1, and then their side ID. So we'll just do 11. There we go. Preferred, 13B, 1, and then you'd add your site. And make sure you always set your site to always preferred so it doesn't roam to theirs if it hears it for whatever reason. There we go. Make sure auto registration is enabled, system determined is enabled, and your unit ID is correct. I recommend refresh price pro scan adjacency list. And then as far as the emergency option goes, DVM does not support emergency alarm. They never will. Don't ask. Please. Thank you. And now we can hit OK. Nothing will pop up. And then we'd go down to, where is it? General options. Make sure allow P25 unsolicited affiliation is enabled. Noise cancellation if you have a 75, an XG75 or XG100. I think that's a thing on 100. Only if you wish. Noise suppression is also nice. AGC is also nice, along with voice assist. Use customizable audio to adjust your gains as well. Keypad options. Recommend just leaving them right where they are, except for ramp wrap. And then portable radio options. Make sure you have this set up properly. Do be advised of the battery alarm settings. Some county units have those disabled for whatever reason. Power up options. Audible tone enables a little beep as it turns on, like you would a Motorola. Private mode enables encryption basically by default. Whenever you turn it on, you can still disable it. Scan is scan state. Scan means on or off, basically. There you go. You can also select if you wanted to automatically go to system-wide ops on power-up. Okay. As far as programmable menus go, make sure you have everything that needs to be in there. Then supervisory options. Last system group recall is very nice to have enabled. And then you can, if you wish to have emergency calls, we don't use them for anything, so there's really no point. And then system scan, this is very important. If you wish to scan across different areas in a wide area scan, select wide area, scroll back up to systems, and if you say we added in another system, call this 11, fill this out with information. Shoot, I forgot which one. Now let's do another CTRS site. You'd basically just hit add to scan list. There you go. Delete that. So there. And that's all you need to do. Thank you very much. As usual, just give us a call if you have any questions. Thank you.